So
good evening.
Now we welcome to the respected dignitaries on and off the dais, dear colleagues, teachers, scholars, librarians, students, and all other participants. Welcome to you all. Department of Library and Information Science, University of Calcutta has completed glorious 75 years. We are organizing seminars, lectures, and other programs all through the year to celebrate this glorious existence. Today's first lecture is Media and Information Literacy by Professor Jagtar Singh. As we know, it conveys how knowledge, attitudes, skill sets to know why, when, how, what about the media and information literacy. So water everywhere, nor a drop to drink. As we know that information is everywhere, but we have to know how to find it, where to find it, and when to find it. From all the WH questions will be answered today by Professor Singh. Let me introduce you to our first speaker now. Professor Jagtar Singh is former professor and head Department of Library and Information Science, and also former Dean, Faculty of Education and Information Science, Punjabi University, Patiala, India. He guided 14 PhD scholars, published 100 papers and 10 books, out of which most notable are UNESCO's MILID yearbooks for the year 2015 and 2016. He received many awards, including Commonwealth Academic Staff Fellowship, FLA, PLA Professor MP Tafija Award, Pakistan Library Association's Lifetime Achievement Award, ILA Dr. PhD Kumar Lifetime Achievement Award. He was the president of Yatlis for 2 terms. He has developed several models, including HIL model, ERTIS model, MIL model, HS model of education. His research interests are manifold, including LIS education, media and information literacy, knowledge organization, digital democracy, information ethics. Today's program will be chaired by Professor Biplab Chakraborty. Now I will request Professor Singh to start his lecture.
Speaker is unmute. Speaker is to unmute.
Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Hello?
Yes.
Yes, sir, we can hear you. Yeah.
You can hear me.
And we can see
so
the PPT also.
I was saying, you can hear me now?
Yes.
Okay. First of all, I take this opportunity to thank the University of Calcutta authorities to associate me with the 75th year of the department and the university, and giving me opportunity to share my perceptions on media and information literacy, and I am also deeply grateful to Sushmita Chakravarti, professor, for introducing me to the participants of this lecture. So I had been working with UNESCO since last 10-15 years on media and information literacy. So today I am focusing on media and information literacy is needed for information engagement, participation and empowerment of people. So before I start the topic, I want to tell you the context in which context we are discussing this media and information literacy. So the purpose of any higher educational institution is creation and dissemination of knowledge. And libraries are to support the higher educational institutions and wherever other creative things are taking place with preservation of documentary heritage and providing access to knowledge. And education is time-specific process to build desirable capabilities, competencies. But learning is a lifelong process to bridge the gap between the rhetoric and the reality. So there should not be any gap between what we are saying and what we are doing. It means there should be the gap between the theory and practice must be bridged. Now, what are the media and information literacy relics? Means, but what is our heritage? That is data, information, knowledge, values, ethics, and aesthetics. And what are the mill harbingers? But what are the new things which are changing every moment? These are our feelings, thinking, actions, rhetoric, reality, and the information and communication technologies. Now, what we expect from media and information literacy? Media and information literacy must promote critical thinking. Critical thinking does not mean that we are to criticize. It is means we are to discuss the things on the merit. We are to find out the truth behind the story. Independent learning. Now we are to promote learning. We are to promote critical thinking. We are to promote resource-based student-centered learning. And then we are to recognize the leaders who are doing good work in the field of media and information literacy. Now, what are the catalytic agents? These are common sense and wisdom. So George Bernard Shaw has said that common sense is not so common. That is needed for tactical decisions, but wisdom is needed for sustainable decision. But what is the missing link? Lack of massive timely access to quality information. So that is the mandate of the libraries and information centers, that we are to provide massive, timely access to quality information. When I am talking of access to information, I am talking bibliographical access, what is available, where located, and how to get it. Similarly, physical access, the document should be in your hand. And then language access. If you start talking in Bengali, I won't understand. If I start talking in Punjabi, you don't understand. So there should be a common translation or language access. And finally, intellectual access. If I am talking something about media and information literacy, the participants of this webinar must be able to understand the concept and practice of media and information literacy. Now, what is the way out to promote this critical thinking, independent learning, and recognition? It is promoting media and information literacy across frontiers. When I say across frontiers, it means that it should start from we are to catch young, the children. Across frontiers, we are to promote media and information literacy among general people, among scientists, among faculty members, among researchers, among students, among senior citizens, and across physical boundaries or the geographical boundaries as well for peace and progress. And this peace and progress and harmonious living is very important in a country like India, which is a composite culture. There are different languages, different cultures, and intercultural and interreligious dialogue is very much necessary for peaceful coexistence and harmonious living. And that can be promoted with media and information literacy. So we can do it by putting media and information literacy and e-artists mill model to practice. Now, why e-artist model? Other models like Big Six and Empowering It more focus on information literacy only, but this e-artist model focuses on media and information literacy. Now, what is happening? There is a scent of intangibles. Intangibles mean entities are of two types, tangibles and intangibles. Tangibles diminish with use, but intangibles grow with use. As I am sharing my knowledge on media and information literacy, I am not losing anything, but the participants may be gaining something. So, we have moved from this nomadic society to agricultural society to information society and finally to information and knowledge society, and we are heading towards this attention society. So, knowledge and information is the core of our decision making and problem solving. There is information overload, and the information seekers are overwhelmed by this information deluge. So there is this information overload is leading to information stress, and you know stress is the silent killer. That's why media and information literacy is necessary, so that we are able to process the information and we are able to use the information. Now, what are the domains of information, knowledge and wisdom? Domain of information is decision making. Domain of knowledge is problem solving. And domain of wisdom is to control negative applications of this knowledge and information. You see, making an atom bomb is a product of knowledge, but throwing it on Nagasaki and Hiroshima is not a wise decision, was not a wise decision. So, mill is to promote construction, not destruction. So, challenge is ensuring timely access to quality information in an affordable manner. So, if that manner is not affordable, then we have libraries, information centers, and networks. So, here I am talking about 4DL. 4DL means learning is a lifelong process, and there are four pillars of learning according to UNESCO. First is learning to know, developing your competencies, knowledge, attitude, and skills. And then learning to do. You should be able to practice what you preach. And learning to be, you should be able to become what you want to be. And finally, learning to live together, in a particularly in a country like India. Now, origins of information literacy. First time this concept was promoted by Paul G. Jorkowski in 1974, when he said that it includes techniques and skills necessary for utilizing a wide range of information tools and primary sources. His definition of information literacy also included the ability to measure information value, to mold information to meet one's needs, and create solutions to problems. So there is a journey from information literacy to media and information literacy. Media and information literacy is necessary to decode the motive of the mainstream media. Mainstream media is controlled by politicians, governments, and corporate tycoons. You have seen in elections how, with the help of drone, they promote that large number of people are attending the rally, and perhaps a particular party is going to form government. You have seen it in West Bengal also, how they are brainwashing the people's brains. But media and information literacy gives you the skills and gives you the competencies to decode the truth behind the story. Now, Christine Bruce has done very good research on seven faces of information literacy. She has identified that in the people, when she was doing the research, she has identified seven groups. There was one group who was thinking that anybody who knows information technology is information literate. Another group was thinking that sources of information. If you have knowledge of sources of information, you are information literate. Another was saying information process dimension. Means when you are able to make decisions and solve problems, you are information literate. And then information control, when you are able to organize information, communicate information, control information, and use information ethically and legally, you are information literate. then knowledge construction. When you are able to convert information into your tacit knowledge, you are information literate. But when you are able to write good research paper and share that knowledge with other society record, the tacit knowledge, you are doing that knowledge extension and wisdom construction. When you are able to use that knowledge wisely. But Christine Bruce and I believe that this individual is not information literacy. This holistic attitude, when you have all the seven faces integrated into your tacit knowledge base, only then you are information literate. Now there are various models, Big Six model. That is American model. It is saying that an information literate person goes through these six tips. Task definition. First of all, you have to define whether you are going to do PhD, whether you are going to write an assignment or keynote address, whatever, or you are going to write a book. Then you are to develop your information seeking strategy. You must know what is available, where located, and how to get it. Then you have to locate that information and access that information. I have already told you four types of access: physical, bibliographical access, physical access to information, language access to information, and then intellectual access. You should be able to understand and use of that information ethically and legally. And then you have to synthesize. When you have collected the data, you have to write your thesis. And finally, evaluation. Evaluation will be done by the expert, and then you are to give your decision. So this Big Six model is not a complete model. That's why there was another model, Empowering Eight model of information literacy. It includes eight steps, but you see there are two cycles. These two cycles represent librarian and the teacher of library and information science. So there are eight steps to identify your information need, explore various sources of information, select best of the best information source, organize the retrieved information, then to create a document, present that document to the expert, then assessment will be there, then you will get the feedback, you have to apply that feedback, and then again that cycle will go on and on. So that is the model, which contains eight steps. This model was developed in Sri Lanka with the help of funding from UNESCO and IFLA. It was developed in 2004. Now, this is e-artist's mill model. This is developed by me, Jagtar Singh, and Elton Grizzel. He is program specialist in UNESCO. Because the previous models deal with information literacy only, but here the focus is on media and information literacy. I have already told you that media is controlled by the politicians, governments, and corporate tycoons, and they have their profit moves. So there are various issues related with disinformation, misinformation, malinformation, and fake news. Conspiracy theories are there. So we need media and information literacy to obtain our personal, professional, educational, and social goals. Now, what is disinformation? Misinformation is that wrong information is circulated without harming anyone. There is no bad intention. But disinformation is that wrong information is deliberately distributed to harm the people or the community or to target people. Fake news is when there is no truth in the story. Malinformation is when you remove the context and you try to mislead the people. Now, there are various acronyms. E-artist. E stands for explore. In this model, you are first of all to explore your information need. And then A means then you are to simulate information from different sources of information. R means you are when that information goes into your tacit knowledge base, your personal knowledge, you are to reflect whether that information is true or not, and you are to critically evaluate that information. Then you are to truncate the irrelevant information which you don't trust. Finally, you are to integrate that information. If you are writing that the PhD thesis or book, you are to integrate the truncated information, the real information, relevant information, quality information into your assignment. Finally, you are to share, whether it is a research article or a PhD thesis, you are to share that. And when you share that, when there is a real research and it is validated, it will certainly transform the existing body of knowledge in your field of specialization. And finally, we are to sensitize that if I could do good work with the help of this e-artist mill model, you should also promote media and information literacy and sensitize people about the need for media and information literacy. Now here I am made comparative study of Big Six model, empowering it model of IL and E artists mill model. Now comments are there that E artists model implies identification. E8 and Big Six model ignore assimilation of information. E8 model is near to E artist's mill model. Mother, there are emotional biases which E artist model says that we should truncate those emotional biases. Integrate E artist mill model is open to diversity of opinion, respect for difference of opinion. Share, transfer, and sensitize. E artist mill model focuses on the right to be. It means when the child goes to the school, parents force them to become doctors and engineering. But e-artist mill model says that we are to realize the potential of the information seeker. He has the right to be. He should become whatever he wants to be. So media and information literacy and e-artist mill model promotes it. Now, why we need media and information? Media and information literacy basically means decoding the media motive. What is the motive of the media? If Malo government is promoting information, if any political party is promoting information, if politicians are promoting information, if corporate sector is promoting information, what is the motive? The reason is visible, but motive is not visible. Media and information literacy trains us to ascertain the truth behind the story. It is needed for reinforcing human rights. So, IFLA FEFI, you have seen freedom of access to information and freedom of expression are the human rights and ensuring good governance. If we are media and information literate, we make choices, sound choices on the basis of quality information, then we will elect good government and there will not be any corruption. There will be transparency. There will be no discretion, no discrimination. Media and information literacy is necessary for promoting intercultural and interreligious dialogue. So India, there are various cultures. So we must understand the respect for different cultures. And similarly, there are different religions and we should respect the religions. Harmonious religion and culture should not be for division. It should be for unity, unity and integrity of India. Harmonious living and sustainable development. You see, there are 17 sustainable development goals and media and information literacy is to support obtainment of those sustainable goals. It is necessary for countering discrimination, radicalization and extremism. You see radicalization and extremism, terrorism. This is creating problems worldwide and media and information literacy can help us in countering fake news, countering hate speech. Lot of hatred is generated on the media, in the internet, on the WhatsApp groups, and there are conspiracy theories. You see, when COVID-19 came, previously it was thought that the Tablighi people are spreading this COVID-19, and there were lot of controversies, conspiracy theories. But if we are media and information literate, we can counter this misinformation, disinformation, malinformation, and the internet trolling, where people are trying to create emotional triggers and we are trying to ignite the sentiments and emotions of the people. Now UNESCO is doing, UNESCO is using it as a composite culture, media and information literacy, and it has many initiatives, Mill Alliance, anybody can be member free of charge. Previous its name was Gap Mill, Global Alliance for Promotion of Media and Information. Global Alliance for Partnerships on Media and Information Literacy. Then Millard University Network is there. It is the research arm of this Mill Alliance. Mill Toolkit is there. These are documents are freely available. Mill Policy and Strategy Guidelines, Mill Curriculum for Teachers. It is a very good document if you want to introduce in master's course your media and information literacy paper. This is freely available. You can download the PDF copy and introduce Mill Framework. What is information literacy? What is media and information literacy? What is media literacy? You can. Mill indicators. What are the indicators on the basis of which you can say an institution, an individual, or a nation is Mill literate? Besides, there is this toolkit, there is a Millard yearbook. I have edited the 15 and 16 editions of Millard yearbook. So that is Millard yearbook for sustainable development goals. Second, 16th edition is in 2016, it was media and information literacy for reinforcing human rights and countering radicalization and extremism. Then Mill MOOC course is there. It can be done freely. It is by University of Athabasca, Canada, and UNESCO and University of Athabasca gives you the certificate. It is free of charge. You are not to pay anything. Then every year there is a Mill Week feature conference and youth agenda forum by UNESCO. Anybody can contribute. Now well, the announcement has been flashed, and if you search this Mill Week feature conference and youth agenda forum 2021, you will get all the information. And recently the July issue of DESIDOC Journal of Library and DESIDOC Journal of Information Technology special issue has been published. This is volume 41 and number 4. This is the URL. So if you go there, you can find many articles on media and information literacy. So these are 5 laws of media and information literacy. These are available on the UNESCO website. You see here, these are developed by Elton Grizzle, program specialist, and Jagtar Singh, that is me. So these are 5 laws. So we have got the cue from 5 laws of Ranganathan, but here these 5 laws are focusing. The first law is that information providers are equal in status. None is above or below. Second is media and information literacy is for all the people of the world. And number 3 is that there are biases and media and information literacy should train you in evaluation skills so that you are able to decode the truth behind the story. Then fourth law is media and information literacy is a human right and everybody should have freedom of access to information and freedom of expression. And fifth law is that learning is a lifelong process and media and information literacy must promote lifelong learning. So these laws are available on the UNESCO website. If you search UNESCO 5 laws of media and information literacy, you will get it. These are translated into all the 6 languages of the world. Now, I am giving you, you see how peaceful you are finding. This is what Mother Nature is giving us. Mother Nature is very calm. It has lot of things for you to satisfy your need, but it has nothing to satisfy your greed. Now you next see, his need is only that he needs food. He has got the food, the dog, it has got the food. Now it is sleeping comfortably because his needs are fulfilled. But now you see what man has made of man. This is an Israeli girl, a Palestinian girl, when there was attack and her parents were killed. Now this is happening. That's why I am saying that media and information literacy is needed for reinforcing human right. Everybody has right to live like with dignity, and everybody has right to, I mean to say, live and let live. That is media and information literacy promoting. Now this is misinformation, disinformation, and malinformation. How people are misleading the people. I have told you misinformation is, I'm going to finish.
No, sir. sir, can you put your video on, please? Put your video, video on, sir. Your video, okay, stop. Video on.
Just a minute. CGI. Just a minute. So misinformation, disinformation and malinformation. Misinformation, I have told you that misinformation means when wrong information is spread innocently without any intention of harming. Disinformation is when wrong information is spread with malafide intention, harming a person, harming a group, harming a community, harming a nation. Malinformation is when you remove the context. Here you see, if you see this picture, this context of pond is removed and we feel very bad about this dog, that that dog is trying to eat the innocent sheep. But when you go, you do the fact checking, you find, no, the dog is not trying to eat. The dog is trying to pull the sick sheep out of the pond who is going to die by drowning. So this is malinformation. This is the true information. This is the doctored information to bias, to create bias. So that is media and information literacy is needed to help you evaluate information and find truth behind the story. Bottom line, because we are running out of time, bottom line is information literacy and media and information literacy are necessary for finding needle in the haystack or shooting the moving object of information. The haystack of information deluge is growing day by day. You see, internet is the vast storehouse of information and a perpetual symposium of minds is going on the internet. And see how much information is social media platforms is coming. So the consumers are becoming prosumers. So media and information literacy is necessary to handle this deluge that is growing day by day, and the needle of relevant information is being buried deep down under this deluge. In fact, information is the fish and the media and information literacy is the art of fishing. Don't give them the fish. Simply teach them the art of the fishing. Teach the citizens art of the fishing. If they know media and information skills, then they will find the truth behind the story. Then there will be human rights. There will be intercultural dialogue. There will be interreligious dialogue. There will be peaceful living. There will be harmonious living. There will be no discrimination. There will be no corruption. There will be no discretion. Only thing is that we should promote information literacy across frontiers. Information literacy must be part of media, and information literacy must be part of this national education policy. Similarly, it should be in the curriculum. Everywhere there should be media and information literacy part. There should be core component. Similarly, we have national literacy mission and national mission on libraries. And media and information literacy must become a part of national mission on libraries. So thank you very much for your time and attention, and also thank you very much for associating me with your Golden Jubilee celebrations. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Professor Singh. Actually, we now know that media and information literacy will help in our critical thinking, as well as recognizing others' point of view, will make us an informed consumer of products, an intelligent user, and will help us in ethical information use. So it is as Professor Singh told us so clearly, it is this information literacy is deeply connected with malinformation, misinformation and other types of abuses of information. And I will request other guests to keep their camera and audio on, please. So now we will have our speaker, second speaker, Dr. Arun Kumar Chakraborty, speaking on media, after media and information literacy, it is turned to move over to fake news, societal impact. So let us first introduce him. He has admirable CV. So we will have just a few lines. Professor Dr. Chakraborty is now serving as the head of the CSIR Research Institute, Bose Institute Information Center, catering to the renowned scientists all over the country and across globe. And he was a Fulbright scholar in the Virginia Tech University. He was the former Director General of National Library of India, as well as Director General former of RRLF, Government of India. He has supervised a few PhDs, as well as he has taken so many classes in MPhil and other courses in different universities. He has taught in refresher courses of different universities, as well as he has programmed several workshops, and he was the chair of many important committees all through the working life. So we are fortunate to have you, sir. Over to you, Dr. Chakraborty.
Thank you, Professor Sushmita Chakraborty. First of all, first I will give my respect and regards to all the departments of the entire University of Calcutta, because 75 years Silver Jubilee celebration is not a matter of joke. So 75 years the university is in a topmost ranking, and every year it is progressing. So all of them have contributed to become this university is one of the best university in the country. So we are proud of this, and I am really grateful to the university and all the departments, head and all the professors who are in the department, for giving me this opportunity to share our and this platform. And I'm also very, very fortunate to having our previous speaker, Professor Jagtar Singh sir. He is very, very well known to me for a long time. We have been in a different dais for a long time. Whenever we hear, we really, he mesmerized us. He's giving a very, very important information and all. So after his lecture, it's very difficult to deliver a lecture, because he has given you so much bubbling all information, and then through that information it is very, very difficult for you to do this kind of things. So now I will just share my screen. 1 minute, just a share screen, Windows. Share screen. Let me see. That's what is that? Share screen. Screen shares are distinct to motion screen shares. What is that? It's not sharing, no?
No, not yet. No, it is sharing. Now it is coming. So you select the screen.
What is okay. The screen? Yeah. I'm not able to see that screen. That's our main. What is the choose?
You just go, you go out of sharing screen and.
Which one? Where should I go?
I don't know. Then share screen.
That's given already, but all the files are not coming.
That shared screen sharing.
Sincerely, okay? I'm human, but it's not
share screen. You know, just share screen, that blue thing. Okay.
I've given only, but it's not coming. Share screen. Has come? No.
No. Share screen. Then share screen.
Then
blue button.
Blue button, why is it? Blue button is not good. Share screen.
Share screen. Then share screen.
Share screen.
Then share screen. And then there are the options. Don't take the options. In the lower thing, that blue portion is there. Share screen.
No, that is not coming. That share screen is not coming. That blue button is not on. That is coming. Share cancel is coming.
No.
That's only is coming cancellation.
Okay. So you want to WhatsApp me?
Otherwise, let me. I'll just
tell. You can talk.
Just 15 minutes.
Take another minute, and you can send me the.
Now yes, now it's come.
Exactly. It will come.
Now it will come. Wait, just.
Don't get stressed.
Now it will. 1 minute.
It will come.
Share screen. Share, then video file. Video file.
No, not video. The lower blue thing.
Lower blue thing is not coming.
Okay.
In the share screen, that I have to share screen. Share screen. 1 minute. Share screen.
Apni ki amake PPT ta mail kore debe.
No. Share screen. Share screen is essential for two.
Share screen.
Then screen is not coming.
Dear participants, let us wait a few minutes for our resource person to for obvious technical difficulties. Okay, just a few minutes. And in the meantime, please write down your questions. Okay. And if your question is meant for one of the party resource persons, please mention the name too. Okay. Okay, sir.
He's sharing your screen. Can you see?
Yeah.
Can you see? I've already shared. Can you see?
Yeah. I can see you. Now, please switch on your video. Switch on your video, sir.
Okay.
Thank you. Okay.
1 minute. Switch on video now. What is that? Switch on video. Switch on video. Start camera. Yeah. Now is okay. You can see now. Hello.
Yes, sir. We can see you.
Yeah, we can see you now. Okay. Now is okay now.
Now is okay. Yeah. You can start, sir.
Okay. No problem. Fake information. Our societal impact that was given by Professor Sushmita Madam. So I had to speak on that. So what is a fake information? So that's already Professor Jagtar Singh has already covered. That means written or verbal statement or representation of fact that is not true and that was made intentionally, knowingly, or without having taken reasonable steps to ascertain whether or not the information was true. And false information provides on a bidder's affidavit of availability. And false information given concerning the death, immunity, or relationship shall be cause for the discharge. False information, a person must not, in connection with a requirement by the department CEO under the 77th Act or the misleading information in particular. So what is a fake information? If we see that fake information with internet to cause public servant to use his lawful power to the inquiry of another person. And false information means any incorrect or inaccurate information concerning the name, date of birth, social security number, driver's license, all this fake information people provide to protect their identity, keep the identity not known to anyone, so that then they can do all this misinformation. So false information means any information that is not based upon the reasonable and reliable scientific inquiry, facts or data, and that directly indicates that a perishable agriculture or aquaculture product is not safe for human consumption. So fake information means data and that represents the caller's identity to the recipient, a call or a network itself. However, when a person making an authorized call on behalf of another person insert the name, telephone number, or name the telephone or the person whose behalf he is calling being made, such information must not be deemed as a false information. So what is fake news? In Wikipedia, it states that fake news is a type of yellow journalism or propaganda, and that constitute a deliberate misinformation or hoax and spread via traditional print, broadcast, news media, and online social media. So you can see that I'm not going through full, so you can find out that. So fake news is a term that refers to the news outlet that pretends to be real but are actually fake. Fake news include false stories about all sorts of topics that are crafted in order to appear real and get traffic and social share on Facebook or in a Twitter. And while fake news stories like the satire or the one of the from the Onion have been around for the years, they had never been more prevalent than during the 2016 race for POTUS. During the election, many fake news stories were released to deceive people into the belief of conspiracy theories and other false claims. Many believe that the rise in the fake news is due to the diminishing newspaper and journalist and social media user willingness to share stories without the fact checking. What already Professor Jagtar Singh says, that media literacy. Media literacy is most important for spreading this fake news. So fake news are frequently used to describe political story, which is damaging to an agency or entity or a person. However, it is by no means restricted to the politics and seems to have a currency in terms of general news. General news. And what is the fake news? What is its definition? What are the types and how to detect them? So fake news, the term fake news allude to report images and videos that are shared to purposefully spread misinformation, that is information that is factually incorrect. These news items may appear authentic at first and attempt to attract attention, shock, or shape opinions. Fake news can be created individual by group and who are acting in their own interest or those of third parties. And the creation and misinformation is usually motivated by personal, political, or economic agenda. Sometimes what you know, we get information and we just circulate. We do not know whether it is fake or not. Suddenly something is making us energetic or something like this, so we circulate. So fake news is referred to the false reports or misinformation and shared the form of articles, images, or videos which are distinguished as a real news and aim to manipulate people's opinion. Fake news is spread by a social media users and hidden in social bots, which comments on, repost, and retweet such news items. What types of fake news are existed? There are four types of fake news we can see. One is a targeted misinformation. Fictitious piece of information shared for self-serving interest. All targeted misinformation is often directed to groups that are most susceptible to receiving this type of information and easily accept and share polarizing content without verifying its authenticity. So this is a targeted misinformation. Then fake headlines. Headlines depict fictitious facts of general attention. These are regularly employed by the less credible and publications such as tabloid newspapers. Readers often quickly realize that the content of the article does not match the headline, and their title are referred to as a clickbait or headlines. virtual posts, there are a plethora of new articles and contents on social media networks. As a consequence, users often do not take the time to authenticate posts because large social networks favor shares like followers, popular posts, shows. And so this WhatsApp university we have, and we always just circulate within a minute. We think that we are the first person to circulating the same news. So that is the mean. Then satire. Satirical news pick up on current affairs and news items and mix them with a fictitious and often absurd events. Satire is often employed to raise awareness of social issues or criticize political wrongdoings. But there are always danger that humorous components go underdetected and pieces are considered to be true. So how to detect these fake news? Verify the social media profile of a sender before you share a post. Ask yourself the following questions. How old is their social media account? Does the account have a blue verification mark? How many followers and friends does the account have? Which type of content are predominantly shared? A few social media accounts with few friends, followers sharing sensational content could point to be a social bot or internet troll. So how to detect the fake news? Verifying the photos and videos. Visual content can be quickly taken out of the context. Watch out for location makers, such as advertising signs, door signs, or car license plates, and check whether they match the image's locations. Another useful tool is reverse image search using URL tools such as TimeEve or Chrome Extensive Review. This can be used to verify when and in which context the picture was published for the first time. Videos are more difficult to authenticate. Intelligent computer editing software allows users to create or deepfake videos, which replaces faces in the original videos, and the YouTube data viewer by immensely international can be used to find original video. So how to detect the fake news? The some websites contain imprint of information on copyright and authors. If this type of information is missing, you should not trust the source of shared content. Check the URL. Some type of fake news take on the design or well-known media brands to evoke trustworthy times. In the case, it is available to verify a URL in a browser. Sometimes the only difference is a hyphen or the domain ending, such as .net or instead of .com, etc. Tip: always check the date of news piece and whether alternative media source are reporting on the same issue. If no alternative trustworthy source are available, it is most likely fake news. So examples of fake news: while some pieces of fake news are relatively harmless, others can cause significant damage because they foster anti-democratic thinking. Experts anticipate that fake news in a combination with social bots have had a major influence on the world events. And world events, here are the three examples of successful fake news which are influenced. AIDS conspiracy. Even before the digitization of information, blind media trust was used to spread wrongful information on behalf of secret services by the GDR and the Soviet Union's West German media in 1980s, spread the news the AIDS virus has been created by the US secret services or CIA. This is called disinformation, what already our side has told you. So while there are some piece of fake news are relatively, then the Bitcoin scam. We can see the Bitcoin scam, then few fake news on imagine immigration crisis. That's also you will find in different places, immigration crisis. So what are the consequences of the fake news on the society? Once celebrated as a democratic medium, World Wide Web has gained a bad reputation when it comes to the reliability of information. Here is the most information that the librarians are the important role in the information correct authenticity of information. See, the librarians or library information professionals are the engaging the authenticate information since the library is there, because there this misinformation was leaflet, pamphlet, all this misinformation used to be spread, misinformation books were there. So the librarians are the first times is this authenticity of the information they have to try. So this means that these are the fake news items or fake information or fake scientific claims, etc. So the librarian has got a huge role because the information is the exploration of information. So that's what we have to be already, Professor Jagdas Singh sir said, the media role has to be in our national new education policy criteria, that should be there. And the library information should be a very, very part of this kind of library, should be given a very, very important of doing this such kind of information hunting. So and what a growing majority people using this online media as their primary source. Fake news is presents huge challenges. On one hand, democracy thrives because freely accessible information, which helps us understand political, societal, economical, scientific, all types of connections. On the other hand, fake news fosters mistrust and skeptical thinking and hinder discussions or a conflict resolution. So what's the threat in fake news? Really a threat to the society? Is it really a threat to the society? Or is it not just badly doctored videos that are shared for fun like memes? Is not the fake news just a buzzword? Or is not an insult when you don't like a particular story? Don't you know the fake news comes from the same sources? So it's easy to recognize. The threat of the fake news is that fake news creates a false reality, and not just one or two people buy into it, but thousands. And it creates a reality that those creating the fake news can manipulate to whatever they want it to be. Those lies, if continued to be perpetrated, can turn deadly or threaten to the societal stability. So the aforementioned report by the Pew Research Center found that Americans rank the problem of made up of news and information higher than the problems of violent crimes, climate changes, and racism. It's just a threat. Over the half those surveyed in our report, they have received a report and want to spreading the fake news to be considered is a crime. Sorry. Fake news is a crime. So therefore, so while European respondents did not see the fake news as a being as a big threat to the society as climate changes, data theft, or the terrorism, 60% still believe that fake news influenced the elections in their various countries. A much higher amount of US respondents believe that fake news also impacted general election. And 70% were convinced the fake news were influenced by the 2016 presidential elections. So in fake news is really threat to the society. So it's just badly doctored videos that are shared. Critically thinking is a key skill in the media and information literacy. So now how to spot fake news is given by the IFLA. So the IFLA is also working on this fake news. That's what I'm telling the library professionals have to have a very critical role. So critical thinking is a key skill in media and information literacy. And the mission of the libraries is to educate and advocate its importance. So discussions about fake news has led to a new focus on media literacy more broadly and role of libraries and other education institutions in providing this. When the Oxford Dictionary announced that post-truth was word of the year 2016, we as a librarian realized action is needed to educate and advocate for critical thinking, a critical skills when navigated the information society. So IFLA has made this infographic with 8 simple steps based on the fact-checking 2016 article to disorder the verifiability of a given piece of in front of you. Download, print, translate, and share at home, at your liberty, in your local community. So you can go to this website and you can find, I am not able to share that series because you have to change your distance. So now there are different tools and technologies for detect this fake news. There are AdBlock Plus, Bad News, Bot Scanned. Then there is a bot, bot meter, bot silver, Captain Fact, then Centrified Content Coalitions, Czechoslovakia, Clan Blasters, Climate Feedback, Crash Course Media Literacy Videos, the Crash Course Videos YouTube, then Checkbox. So role of the so that means the already says so role of the media is the first important for this fake news. The fake news, the media, not only that this one. So in order to successfully promote and preserve our culture, it is necessary to communicate various arts, forms of the rich culture and heritage of the masses. So that means the fake news is very important for us, because of any fake news, it is a really a challenge. It is a culture of the society. The culture, when we are culturally or mentally becomes crippled, then this fake news is becoming more important. So that means our mental information, mental balance, mental education is very, very important for us fake news spreading. So that is knowledge and education or any media technology learning is very, very becoming important. So documentation, content generation, media spread masses. So what is this content generation, documentation, packaging of masses, storage and transfer, and then choosing the right media, and then dissemination of the communication. So that means if we want to really give a process of information, so it should be a content generation, it should be a packaging of message of information, which should be text, image, graphic, audio, video, storage, then transfer and exchange, then choosing the right media, print, video, TV, web media. So dissemination and communication. So the librarian has to do all these things, has to think of that when we do any of information. So feedback, dissemination, communication. So these are the checkpoint for our library professionals to find out, yes, really we are learning to the fake news or not. That's most important part of these things. So I will not go much on this. So I think I've already covered of this information. So in this thing, we have a very less time that we understand. So I'll show some of this. This is, content is a king. We know that different tools of fake news, you will find that even the Supreme Court, the Supreme Court is now being given different ruling. If you go to the check in this website, you will find there's tools in the news of Supreme Court, trolls, fake news, and more. Supreme Court agrees there should be rules to stop this social media abuse. If you search in the Supreme Court and different courts orders and all, you'll find huge order of these things. Everybody is becoming puzzled. So they should sit in the Supreme Court to see that how the government is holding up. The bench comprising the Chief Justice of Deepak Mishra and Justice A.M. Khullar and Chandras has observed untraceable comments, trolls, aggressive reactions on social media platforms to almost every issues, including the judges and judicial processings, came under the scanner of the Supreme Court. So these are the troll and fake news. If you go to this website of the fake news, I have got the 6 lakhs, this much of results the Google is giving. But you know that Google, if we go to this Google teacher, that also giving it spread a lot of fake news. So finding this fake news also, the Google, if you depend on the Google, that is really becoming a defensive. So we have to know that content is a king and food is in the garden. So content has to be very, very important. If the content in food in the garden is the content is in the garden is not important, the content is the king. And content event, we have to think of that, how these contents are idea are generated. So all these things you have to know, the content news update, the Biasat, all these. Then content idea campaign, use appeal to take action, simplify. Can we do something? Overcharging cross-departmental campaigns to advance our missions. So contents, ideas, stories, important days, attraction, dailies, how these contents are created. So contents, idea, visual communication, images, videos, Twitter, Facebook, videos, short videos, Vine, or context is the God. So context idea, content idea, live tweeting, deliver live information to audience and more. So we should give a correct content to the people, correct content. So media literacy is important to prevent this fake news. So that's what already Professor Jagtar Singh sir has said. So some more content ideas, squeezing privacy, press release, domain-specific content, engage with the influencer, positive news mentions of your organizations, and then cross information. So all these things are platform we have to do. So all the, so now I will say that though, get the processing do's and don't do's. What to post, how often, when we become, when, by whom, what types of conversation to enter into it, approval process, social media content calendar, example, important days and scheduling of post. How to do these errors and mistakes. So PIB of India, we have to see that first approval of India, which is submitting information. So we should always check from that whether is this news are correct or not. So you have to do. So thank you very much. I think I'll stop here because there is not much time. So I'm really thankful to the department. Again, once again, I thank to the department and entire the department present team and the entire team of the last 75 years who have been contributing to the university development. And not only that, the university has produced huge number of PhD students, MSc students, MA, all this, they are in different places. So they are all assets. So if we need a really directory of these things. Thank you very much for giving me this opportunity.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Now, I will request all our distinguished dignitaries, Professor Chakraborty and Professor Singh, and to come on the dais. We will have the question answer session now. Okay, so we will take one by one the questions. And Professor Chakraborty, can you please switch on your video, sir? And the questions will be addressed to the dignitaries. And yes, out of three of you, anyone can answer. Okay, that will be up to you. Okay. So the question has come. So Professor Dr. Chakraborty, can you take this?
How do we identify a fake news?
Yes.
See, first of all, I have given already that there are different criteria. It's not that in a one go itself is a fake news. First of all, we have to see that authenticity of the information, from where it has come. See, whenever sometimes it happens, no, one friend he got and he is circulating to other friends. So that becomes difficult to find out the authenticity. So when you get information from a particular friend, you ask him that, yes, this information where you have got, from which sources you have got. So you have to find out first what are the sources. And then another one, you have to see with the whether the similar kind of information is available in a news media or somewhere where the authentic information are available. So the correct media, the authentic media. So if that information is telling, then that is not fake news. So it is first of all that we have to be very calm and fast. The immediately we should not be get excited that you get a news and immediately you would spread. That's our attitude or what you call our things. That's yes, we got a certain news. We immediately think that yes, we'll spread our 10 friends. So before that, you have to be very, very calm. Yes, whether it is correct or not, let us see first and then only distribute.
Professor Chakraborty, do you want to add on that? The question was, how do you identify a fake news? Do you want to add some to whatever Dr. Chakraborty has said?
Dr. Chakraborty has already answered it very nicely. First of all, the basic norm is that never trust any news, that it is true story, and then verify it from different channels. See, it is information, it is source, and the source. What is the authenticity of the source? You have to see. So I have already told you that media controlled by governments, politicians, and corporate tycoons. From where that information is coming, that comes with a motive. And you should always try to decode the motive and check it from various fact-checking sites. and you will come to know what is the truth behind this story.
So I will request, Acha, there is another question. This is for Professor Singh, I think.
Yes, how does male play a role in preventing war situation? So that's why I'm saying media and information literacy is for critical thinking and independent learning. See how people are ruling us. They are creating boundaries. They are creating colonies on our minds. And if we are media and information literate, see, people are talking of classes. I tell you, there are only two classes. One is the ruling class and another is the ruled class. So ruled class should be media and information literate, and then it will elect good government. And if there is a good government, there will be no boundaries. And when there is no boundaries, there will be no conflict. The people who want to have power, the people who want to have money, the people who want to control, they are trying to brainwash the people. And media and information literacy will create awareness and understanding among the people about the motive of the people who are controlling the mainstream media. And we are also to create self-regulation in social media, because social media, now this WhatsApp, you, and this Instagram, Flickr, Twitter has cleft all the boundaries. The media, mainstream media, is feeling helpless. But now we are to train the people who are using media and information literacy that we should use that media, social media, responsibly. We are not consumers, we are prosumers. Suppose if somebody is trying to emotionally blackmail me, or is trying to trigger my emotions, if I am critical thinker, I will not be falling into the trap. So why these? What is happening in Afghanistan? What of information is coming, and how we are dealing with that information? And that information is coming from the embedded media. The media is embedded there. The different groups will flashing different information. And we should be media and information literate. There was a war between this Azerbaijan and Armenia, and a lot of information was coming. Similarly, there is a lot of conflict. If we want to resolve that conflict, that is across the table, and whatever war is there, that will be resolved across the table. And for that, media and information literate citizens are needed. So that's okay. If you are free from all the boundaries, how people are exploiting you? By exploiting your religion, by exploiting your language, by exploiting your culture, by exploiting your regional divisions. See, there are national resources. Why there cannot be networking of the waters throughout India? And then we can serve the people. Why we are focusing people paddy and wheat only? Why there cannot be diversification? Why can't we train people that there are different? So we are to decode the motive of the government, motive of the corporate sector. What is happening? Farmers are sitting there since 9 months, and now nobody is listening to them. Why they are suffering? Because they have chosen that government. If they are media and information literate, they will commit that mistake again. Thank you very much.
I will request Professor Biplab Chakraborty to answer this question, sir, from sociological point of view as well as information science point of view. How can we distinguish between misinformation and relevant information? Professor Biplab Chakraborty, sir, please.
Actually, what Professor Jagustha Jagta Singh has told, I am fully agreeable to the proposition. That, presently, the persons, either they may be the politicians or they may be the corporate persons, or they may be the criminal. Everybody, they are trying to misuse the information for their either profit point, or their power oriented point, or their violence creation purpose. So here the other parties, that means the common people, who are the victim of that those persons, they are rightly Professor Jagtar Singh has told that they are have nots. That means the minimum level of standard and the common people who do not have the most potentiality to get the information rightly. So at that point of time, media information literacies and through a number of models Professor Jagtar Singh has told that his five laws of media information literacy model, or e-artist media information model, beside the other big six model and another is seven faces model, or empowering eight model. All these models are actually created for the empowerment of the common mass. That means so to enhance the awareness of the helpless about the rights and duties. What already Dr. Singh has discussed in his answer session, the main motive of his discussion has been reflected in this session, that it is very much important that to ensure intercultural and interreligious dialogue for peaceful coexistence, harmonious living, and sustainable development. This media information literacy model is very much effective, which can promote creative critical thinking, independent learning. So what you have told in your discussion in the moderation time, that social emotional intelligence, access management, and the information evolution skill. So I think that from the sociological point of view, media information literacy model much more helpful for gaining the maximum or output for the persons who are helpless. So I do agree the creation of the such model which is the benefit for the common masses. So that is one, and another one is what Professor Chakraborty has told about the different types of elements of fake news. What is fake news? What types of fake news exist? How to detect fake news? He has given example of fake news, etc. So what are the social media networks are doing fake news, and how to eradicate the fake news? And at that point of time, the role of media information literacy is important, and actually social media can play an effective role in detecting the fake news. So this is also important from the sociological point of time, because sociology deals with the societal people. So society, what society is thinking. So if we get the unimportant information, misinformation or disinformation, malinformation, so there should be there may be the discrimination and discretion. So an injustice will be prevailed. So we would have to be play together for the development of the country and across the world, that there should be the eradication of the fake news. There should be stopped for fake news, and in such cases media social media's role important, and at the same time information and media and informational literacy as a model is very much important and can be an important role in this.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Very informative. So, as Professor Chakraborty aptly put it, this has to deal with empowerment of the disadvantaged people.
Yes.
Next question has come. Professor Singh, please. Hello, Professor Singh, you have to unmute, I think. Sir, you have to unmute, sir.
No, I was telling me information is highly personal. It is a bottom-up system. I have my different information needs. Chakraborty has his own information needs. You have your information needs. So it is highly personal. It varies from person to person, place to place, and time to time. So any misinformation is misleading information, but it's not with a bad intention. But relevant information, if I have a headache, so that the tablet I need to cure my headache. If I have stomach, then there's a difference. So relevance means any information which is plugging in the gap in your tacit knowledge base. Exactly. What is information need? It's a gap in my tacit knowledge base. Whatever information plugs in that gap, and that is true, that is quality information, that's not fake, there is no emotional bias, that's not old information, that is complete information, there are not emotional integrators. If that information is objective without any biases and relevant to your educational, occupational, social or professional goal, but that's true information, that's relevant information. Now Gurpreet Singh, he is my PhD student, he is asking me question, why developing countries are lagging behind India? Why we are 100 years behind the developed countries? That answers your question. So our self-concept is not that strong. When they are talking of innovation and growth, we are talking of atta dal chini scheme, tea leaves, giving subsidies to the people. Where subsidies are needed, we are not giving. But we are stopping people to do hard work. Similarly, we don't have any national policy of library and information system. We are talking about media and information literacy. India is the country who was having this National Knowledge Commission in 2005. Then we have National Mission on Libraries. But still our public library system is in shambles. It is not in North Indian states you find it's not beyond the district libraries. It is town libraries, not district libraries. So there are many problems. But I think if we are able to educate the people and if we are educate the females at homes, I think we can transform the society. And media and information literacy at the top, it should be in the national education policy, and at the bottom it should start with the schools. Media and information literacy should start from the schools, go to the colleges and then to the universities and then across. There should be PhDs. I have produced 5 PhDs, I think, on media and information literacy and working with UNESCO. We need to build capacity among the people. We should focus immediately on 2 segments, women and youth, and then children, 3 components. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Our next question addressed to Dr. Chakraborty, please. Dr. Arun Kumar Chakraborty. Can you see?
Yes, what is the question? How we can evaluate fake news problems?
How we can evaluate
the fake news problems at the scale of
can we evaluate?
So, okay. See, this is already Professor Jagta Singh has, in our lecture, we have already covered that. And how to evaluate a fake news, it's not like a one formula, your multiple choice questions, yes, no, tick, it is not like that. So if that kind of a fake news, that means you have to be have a very, very cautious of about it. You have no knowledge about it, and then find out that's really what is fake, what is not fake. That's why first of all you have to be very, very calm, and then control yourself that whether it is correct or not, and then you will be able to find out, because always the authentic information is you will have to get in from different sources. If the same information is available in all the channels, that means that may not be the fake news. So if it is only one channel it is available, or if it is only one WhatsApp group is spreading, then it is really a doubtful. So that means you have to be evaluate your authentic information to finding authenticity. That is the most important part of the information seeking behavior. And that is the libraries job also.
Yeah.
It's not that only the fake news. Even the fake information is published in the scientific journals. So that's the people have to reject the journal because of the fake images. That's another problem is coming. The fake information is given in the published journals also, it said. And then suddenly fake news means malinformation, misinformation, manipulating information. What Mr. Jagtar Singh has given different kinds of information segments. So all these things manipulating, it is our in our mind. So that means ethics. Same things all comes that research ethics or ethical information. So until unless we do this ethics and culture, all everything is there, until we are not able to control. And Prof. Jagtar Singh also said that educating people is becoming more. And until unless the entire citizen becomes educated, and then you see especially women and children, then people will think that yes, what is real, what is not real. That is the most important part.
Professor Chakraborty. Professor Biplab Chakraborty, can I request you to take this question?
Which question?
Sometime in news headlines, coming in question marks and exclamation marks. How people think? Please explain about this.
Exclamation mark is when a person is surprised with that news. And question mark is when we are doubting that news. The sensationalization. If you go to the YouTube, you will see. Usko laat mari, usko ye kiya. They force you to read the news, and when you read that news, there is nothing. So that's why people are putting sign of interrogation. What's in this news? And sign of exclamation. I'm surprised. What is in this news? So we must have evaluation skill, and then we should go to the wire. Like you go the wire, if you go to that place you will get the information you can trust. Previously we were having, now what is happening, DD News is distributing the news to every channel. When NDTV was giving a dissent, how many cases were planted on that channel? And they are scared of that their license will be cancelled. That mainstream media is now getting shot from the social media. This YouTube, this Instagram, Flickr, WhatsApp, they have given death blow to the traditional constraints of space and time and mainstream media. Previously, it was very difficult to get this much space to plant your news in the mainstream media. Now there is a lot of space. You have freedom of expression, and you have freedom of expression and freedom of access to information. Only thing is that we should be media and information literate and responsible. What we are going to spread, whether it's malinformation, it's misinformation or disinformation, is it emotional trigger, it's a fake news, or it's a conspiracy theory? We should not spread that. So we should be media and information literate. That's why media and information literacy is very much needed at policy level and at instruction or education level.
So the next question is to Professor Biplab Chakraborty. When fake news is already there in media, how to stop the spread of that, and what to do after the fake news has come? How to deny, how to prevent, how to counter, like that?
Already Professor Jagtar Singh has told that if there is a provision for media information literacy, then it could be can be stopped. because then there are so many models developed by so many persons, and Professor Singh also prescribed two models, one by laws of the institutional model, and another one is e-artist model. So even go through the discussion of Professor Singh, then we can see that there is a provision for exploring, assimilating, reflecting, truncating, integrating, sharing, transforming, and sensitizing. So if there is a question of fake news, then it could be stopped at the bottom line. But if we follow the
The question hour session is over. We will request our chair for our program, Professor Biplab Chakraborty, to give his valuable address. Before that, I will introduce Professor Chakraborty, who definitely needs no introduction, but still I need to introduce his difficult and various deeds that he did all through his life. So he is a master's in sociology, which has really helped him in user study and other things, and the psychology. He has LLB also. So our legal information cell has been triggered by his presence, and he is a gold medalist in library science, not library and information science, because it was library science at that time from Calcutta University. He has done his PhD in a striking area. His work on proto community is the first work on that community, and he is a former members of Senate and Syndicate of Calcutta University. He is also a member of Board of Studies of Postgraduate Studies in several universities, as well as research as advisory committee member of different universities. He is the pioneer of establishing Center of Studies in Book Publishing in University of Calcutta. Now that has been associated with NBT, National Book Trust, and he was the library secretary of Asiatic Society, and he is above all a keen researcher with numerous papers in journals and books. He has quite a few books in his name. We won't go into detail, and he has done awarded money under his supervision. Several PhDs has been awarded, 23 PhDs already has been awarded a few years ago. I don't know the recent count, and MPhil dissertations, definitely half a century it has touched. And his research interests are user study, community information systems and services, LIS education, etc. So over to you, Professor Chakraborty, for your presidential speech.
Thank you, Dr. Sushmita Chakraborty, the head madam of the Department of Library Informational Science of the University of Calcutta. It's a great opportunity for me to be present in this lecture session of the Department of Library Science on the occasion of the 75 years. I feel proud that two eminent personalities in the field of library information science have delivered the lectures on two topics, media information literacy and the fake news, the social impact, which is very much closer to each one. And I feel proud that I am sharing with them about this important and valuable topic on today's discussion. Professor Jagdash Singh has been working for a long time on media information literacy. He, along with I know that Professor Grigal UNESCO has developed five laws of media information literacy model, and artist media information literacy model, and Dr. Arun Chakraborty, former DG of the National Library, and RRLA, now presently working at the Library and Notebooks Institute, has been contributing a good number of lectures on the topic fake news. So both the lectures, I think, are very much have become very essential and important for all of us. Number two is that Professor Jagdish Singh, he has discussed on the media information literacy area, the background of the topic at the last, why the artist model has been developed by him, and he has described a number of areas like information literacy with the definition of Jurkowskin in given the definition in 1974, and then he has described a number of models which are prevalent in the present context, such as seven phases of information literacy, which we have told, big six model, empowering eight model, he has conceived the model of e-artist, media information literacy model, and he has compared all the four, and on the basis of that, e-artist model is open to diversity and focuses information seekers right to be. This is very important connotation, I think. So it is more detailed and understandable than the typical model. Through artists, managing timely access to quality information for quality decision making. From his discussion, we have come to know that he has described a number of UNESCO media information initiatives, like Alliance Immediate End to End, etc., etc. And it is very much known from his lecture that through media information literacy, there may be checking of fake news, hate speech, conspiracy theories, internet trolling, misinformation, disinformation, malinformation, and discrimination and injustice. At the end, at the bottom line, I only quote one line, that the information is fish, and information literacy or media information literacy is the art of fishing. It is very important for all of us. So his description today's on the part on the basis of this lecture, I think very much helpful to the researchers and the students, as well as the common people, including the politician, businessman, and others who are providing information in different ways of different forms of communication. So we know that information literacy the ability to recognize the requirement for information, and the skills used to locate information, a method to assess information, to process, organize, use information ethically and effectively, and so that media information literacy model told by Professor Jagdish Singh is very nice, and he has nicely described within a very short span of time, and I am personally really beneficial. So that I think the participants also will be beneficial for this lecture. And on the part of Arun Chakraborty, my friend, he has told about the fake news and societal impact. So I think it is very much closely related with the information media, information and the social media contents. So he has described the definition of fake news, what types of fake news exist, how to detect fake news, what are the consequences of fake news on society, he has given examples of different fake news, the threat of fake news, what will be the threat. He has given detailed what are the social media networks doing fake news, how to spot fake news by IPLA. He has, and at that point, the role of media and personal literacy is important. He has described and the process of eradication of fake news is from his description. We find that. And a number of initiatives that are already taken by the national and international level, he has told. And finally, the social media, which can play an important role to eradicate the issue, he has described. So his lecture is also important because a number of questions has been emerged from the discussion of the Dr. Arun Chakraborty's lecture, so that people are very much interested in this issue, and they have asked further, so that it may continue, and a number of answers also may be given. But basically, I think that this topic is very much relevant in the present society, because on the basis of the fake news, a number of persons who are greedy, they are providing fake news for their own purpose. So we should be aware about that, and if we aware on the basis of the media information literacy, then fake news can be eradicated, fake news can be avoided. So his important lecture also is beneficial to all of the participants, and particularly to for me. So I think that this lecture session by both the two eminent the persons, eminent personalities, Professor Dr. Singh and Professor Dr. Arun Chakraborty, is very much commendable in the department's 75th lecture session series. So thank you. Over to Sushmita.
Now we have come to the end of the session. We are really glad that such an important event, important area we have covered with these stalwarts of the field. And we are glad that all of you has participated with your time, with your patience, and with your interactions. We are really grateful to all of you. I will specially thank all my colleagues in the department. We have 10 teachers in our department. Professor Biplab Chakraborty, Professor Shopna Banerjee, Professor Pijush Kanti Panigrahi, Professor Aurobindo Maiti, Dr. Shobuj Kumar Choudhury, Dr. Porikhit Mondol, Dr. Bijan Kumar Rai, Dr. Kubalika Bhattacharya Moitro, and Ms. Nikita Lama. Request them to be as lively, as dynamic, as participative as ever in all things. We work together for the successful implementation of the departmental programs. Special thanks to them, to my colleagues, and to our scholars, teachers, and all other participants and dignitaries. I have seen so many teachers are also from different schools, library schools are there. And I will remind you that recording of these programs will be available in the YouTube link given for participation. You can get it from there and get the PPT of both sirs, and you can hear the very useful information provided by Dr. Chakraborty, Professor Singh, especially the tools you are asking for detecting fake information. Tools are there, so please go through that. And I will remind you that registration form must be completed, and feedback form must be submitted with your good and bad comments, and as well as I will request you to be with us all through our journey towards successful implementation of student-friendly and LIS-friendly programs. Thank you. Thank you all. we close the program with this. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Please take care and stay safe.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you very much.